Hello, everybody, and welcome again to another edition of Sports Predictions. We are your hosts, Movie Master Mike.
And Boston Boy.
All right, we are back, and just as mediocre as ever, for Week 17 of the 2014 NFL season. All right, but first, before we get into Week 17, let's get into Week 16, which I didn't post online because just Christmas and working and everything just got too crazy. I never got a chance to edit it and stuff, but we'll do a quick recap and then maybe give our picks.
Okay.
Now, so we had the Titans and the Jaguars. I think we both picked the Jaguars, and the Jaguars won. The Eagles and Redskins, I think we both picked the Eagles, and the Redskins won.
Yeah.
Chargers and Niners, I think we both picked the Chargers, and they barely came back to win it in overtime. Yeah. That was a good game.
Yeah.
All right, Ravens and Texans, I think we both had the Ravens.
Yeah.
And wow, the Texans won at home. So, I mean, I guess that's another one of those things where we usually would go with the home team because they're on par.
Yeah.
But I think we both kind of leaned towards Ravens a little better. That. Yeah. Next, Browns and the Panthers won. I think we both picked the Panthers.
I believe so, yeah.
Yeah.
Manziel was starting, so.
Yeah, yeah, because we're like, Manziel's not going to do anything, so we picked the Panthers.
Yeah.
Lions and Bears, the Lions won, and I think we both picked the Lions because they're just clearly better than the Bears.
Right.
But they barely beat them. And the Packers and Bucks, we picked the Packers, and they did win.
Yep.
Chiefs and Steelers, I think we both...
I can't recall.
I think we both went Steelers because they were the home team. This was one of the coin tosses where we both went home team.
Yeah.
Vikings and Dolphins, I believe we both went Dolphins, and the Dolphins won.
Mm.
Patriots and Jets, we both went Patriots, and the Patriots barely won. Wow, one point. I remember you texted me during the game saying, like, I think we're going to lose this
one. But they took
a
knee at, like, the 5-point line. They could have scored, but you run the risk of fumbling and
marrying. All right, Falcons and Saints, we both picked the Saints to win. And the Falcons won.
Yeah.
They are still winless at home.
Yeah,
and that pretty much ensured the Falcons... that ensured the Saints to not make the playoffs.
Right.
Now it's between the Falcons and the Panthers.
It's home, yeah.
Yeah. All right, then we had the Giants and Rams. We both picked the Rams to win, and the Giants won.
Mm-hmm.
Just playing for pride, I guess.
Yeah.
All right, Bills and Raiders. I think we both picked the Bills to win this one.
Yeah.
And the Raiders ended up winning by 2 points. Good for them.
Yeah.
Colts and Cowboys. I think we both picked the Colts, and the Cowboys won. Just fucking blew them out.
Yeah.
Wow, 42-7. That's crazy. The Colts got the 7 points in the fourth quarter, didn't they?
Right.
Yeah. That's sad. All right, Seahawks and Cardinals. We both picked the Seahawks to win. Sadly,
they won.
They did win. Yeah.
Sure.
And then the Monday night game, the Broncos and Bengals. We both picked the Broncos to win, and the fucking Bengals won. Yes, that's so cool. Oh man, that ensured the Patriots to get the number one seed. We can lose this week
next
17.
Game.
It doesn't matter. We still get the number
2 weeks,
one seed.
Benching our stars if we want. Yeah.
Yeah. So, and we're. I don't think we're gonna.
Right.
But we could if we wanted. All right, moving into week 17, our first game. We've got the Bills at the Patriots.
Bills at Patriots. Bills surprised me when they beat Green Bay a couple weeks ago, and then they surprised me when they lost last week to the Raiders. Patriots, I think even with their second string, this would still be a pretty good game, but I think with them throwing first string in, especially if they start to get into hot water and, you know, don't want to lose the game, I think Patriots will win either way. So Patriots at home.
Yeah, Bills, like, I think you nailed it. Like, what a surprise victory over the Packers.
Right.
What a surprise loss against the Raiders the next week, yeah. So, but they're not making the playoffs anyway, so it doesn't really matter. The Patriots, yeah, like, even if we play our second string, like, we bench, you know, Gronk and Brady and Edelman and
you know, a lot of them are injured. I was watching a little ticker of all their injuries. It's like all of our main offensive players and defensive players are all in they're all injured, so it's just as well we get this week to rest them.
Yeah, so like, but even with like Garoppolo playing and Revis and everybody not playing, or the ones that aren't injured not playing nearly as much as they would in a normal game that mattered,
yeah.
I think we're still going to win.
Right.
It's the Bills. We're at home. Mm-hmm. We're incredibly tough to beat at home.
Yeah.
And I'm actually incredibly interested to see Garoppolo play.
Me too.
Because I didn't get a chance to see the
preseason.
The preseason or
the game where
we put him in, yeah, and the Kansas City game.
Right.
You know, and the only time I did see the game where we put him in at the end, but he was just taking knees.
Yeah.
So
yeah, he did pretty well.
Yeah, like I was reading the stats, like he was like 6 for 7, you know, like he had a touchdown pass to Gronk, so it's like, you know, I'm interested to see him play and actually see what he's got, because Brady, as much as he wants to say he's going to play forever, he's not going to.
Right, of course, yeah.
So it's interesting to see what Garoppolo can do.
All right, so next we have Browns at the Ravens.
All right, Browns and Ravens. Well, what are their records? I think the Ravens have a better record. Yeah, 9-6 and 7-8. Are they still? Are the Browns still Ravens. Starting?
Oh, that's what I was going to ask. I'm not sure.
Yeah, I can't remember.
I think they did say Manziel will continue. No. They did name Hoyer. I think Manziel got hurt. Hoyer's actually starting.
Good.
Yeah.
Yeah, good. But even so, I think the Ravens at home are better. So I'm going to have to go Ravens.
Yeah, I'm with you. It's pretty much like you said. I think Hoyer starting gives them a better chance.
Mm-hmm.
I won't be terribly surprised if they win. The Ravens haven't been doing great lately, but... overall, I think they're a better team, at least in the second half of the season. So, Ravens at home.
Yeah, I know this, if the Ravens win and the Steelers lose, and the Bengals lose, and the Ravens get in?
I think so. They do have, if there was some chain that, yeah, they would
love. Yeah, because all three of those teams, are on the cusp of getting in. So, it really depends on, all three of those games, what happens for whoever to get in. I think the Bengals... If they win, they're for sure getting in.
I think the Bengals are in either way, but it's a seeding issue for them. And then
But
the Steelers are definitely in too.
Are they?
What it is? It's another team. I think Chargers might have had something to do with it.
Yeah, I think it's Chargers and Ravens. Yeah, something to do with that. Like depending on who wins and who loses, they're going to make the playoffs.
Yeah.
But our next game we have the Bears at the Vikings.
For the Vikings. Pretty good one, I guess. they're both pretty bad. 6-9 and 5-10 Bears, 6-9 Vikings. I'm gonna have to either way go with the Vikings at home in this one. The Bears have been that terrible. They're not starting Cutler. Or no, I think I heard that they are starting Cutler because that guy got hurt. Yeah. So. What a sad state of affairs in Chicago. But yeah. Vikings, what a mess.
The Bears, God, they looked good for a while there, in week, 3 and 4, they were looking good, that one awesome, one-handed catch by, Brandon Marshall. I was like, wow, they might do good this year, and nope, every other year, they kind of just fall apart.
Yeah.
But now with the whole controversy of benching Cutler, and
now he's back
in. Yeah, now he's back in, he has to come back in.
But it shows no emotion, both times, he's just, going with the flow, he doesn't,
Yeah.
So if he's pissed off about it, he's not showing it.
Yep. So, I don't know. With all the controversy, even without the controversy, I'd probably have to go Vikings at home.
Yeah.
Just because the Bears still suck.
Yeah. All right. Next, we have Cowboys at the Redskins.
All right, Cowboys and Redskins. Well, the last time they played each other, the Redskins had a surprise victory of the Cowboys. Romo went down in the game.
Right.
Which pretty much ensured the Cardinals to win the next game with their backup in. So. Yeah. But it's tough to beat a team twice. And the Cowboys are better on the road than at home.
Yeah. This is true.
And the Redskins, even with RG3, I think we've both been saying it all year that he's not as good as the hype, but he does give them a better chance to win than their other quarterbacks, McCoy and whoever else.
Can't remember.
Yeah.
Kirk Cousins.
Cousins, yeah. even though, he does give them a better chance to win, it's hard to beat a team twice in a season or ever, season including playoffs.
Right.
So I'm going to go with the Cowboys. They're better on the road, so Cowboys.
Yeah, I hate to agree with you here, but I have to. Redskins win the last game against the Eagles, which, by the way, I'm pretty saddened by. I felt
really, yeah.
That team and the Saints are two. There's quite a few teams really this year that should have made it that are better than some of the teams that are making it.
Yes, there's plenty of those.
But I have to go Cowboys here. Better team all around and
All right. Well, next we got the Jaguars at the Texans.
Jaguars at the Texans. I don't know what really I can say here. I mean, Jaguars are terrible as usual.
They got what 3 wins now? Yep, 3-12.
Yeah, I mean, they're building. Hopefully, they get a better team there later on. But
yeah, I kind of like their jerseys and their helmets and stuff, like the dual color now.
Yeah,
that they have this year.
It's like a brush,
one's shiny, one's the brushed. Dull. Half black, half gold.
Yeah,
it's kind of cool. I like it.
Yeah, it's new and innovative, I guess. But. Yeah. Yeah, not happening this year. Texans are a middling team. Jaguars low end, so, and then the Texans are at home, so Texans.
Yeah, the Jaguars, I mean, they've got a few wins, but the Texans are better. J.J. Watt is a fucking monster. That guy is crazy. I mean, a lot of people talk about making him MVP and stuff because he's so good. Like he's so versatile. I mean, he can play offense. You know, he can score touchdowns. He can catch the ball. So you know, he's not just
a giant.
Yeah, and he has so many sacks. Oh my God! Like he has more sacks than a lot of like teams combined. Like everyone on the team. Like it's crazy.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna go Titans or Texans against the Jaguars. Texans at home for the win.
Yeah. All right. Next we have Colts at the Titans.
Colts and Titans, that is so tough to decide.
The Colts have been playing, but...
Yeah, the Colts have been playing very well. They don't really have a good running game. Like, if Andrew Luck's not heaving it downfield, then they're not playing well.
Yeah, it's up to him, yeah.
Yeah, so... And I said it a few weeks ago, like, I looked and all of a sudden, Luck just throws it like 40 yards downfield. You know, it's like, damn, like, guy's got a rocket for an arm. Like, But that's about all they can do is use his rocket arm. But the Titans suck. I'm going to have to go Colts. They have to win this game. They're in the playoffs no matter what, though, right? Cause
they already clinched
their division. Yeah, they already clinched division, so it doesn't really matter. But so they might not even play Luck.
Right. Even then, the Titans quarterback in Wood Mettenberger got injured, and then they got the Jake Locker. He's injured, so they're with some, I don't even know who.
Yeah, so I'm going to go Colts at home.
Yeah.
Or on the road, I mean.
Yeah. I have to agree. I mean, the Colts, as poorly as they've been playing, although, of course, now his name escapes me, the coach, he was the coach in Arizona.
No idea.
Well, anyway, I like him. It's you know, he's usually really good at...
It's like an Italian name, isn't it? Like Spumoni or something.
Yeah, I don't know why I can't think. Anyway, I'd like to see him do well. He's pretty good usually developing quarterbacks, and they were saying that, I guess in Vegas, the over-under, they're betting on the number of coaches that are going to be fired, and they're saying that it's going to be 6. Like, that's the safe number for them. They think it's going to be, you know, somewhere, you know, it's going to be at least 6 firings. Or
Pagano.
Maybe 5. No, in Arizona.
Oh, the Arizona coach?
Yeah, he was the Arizona.
Oh, Bruce Arians.
No. Not currently. He was prior.
Oh. When,
like, Kurt Warner was there. And.
Oh, yeah, I have no idea.
Yeah, I can't remember. Anyhow, what was I even talking about? I was kind of ranting there.
6 coaches were going to get fired.
Yeah, so, and they were saying he's probably one of them. I mean, I can't imagine. I mean, of course, Rex Ryan and a couple others, but.
Yeah.
My point is I'd like to see him stay. Damn it, I just thought of his name and I forgot. But hopefully he does stay. Hopefully he doesn't get fired.
The guy for the Titans?
Yeah, the current Titans coach used to be Arizona coach.
Oh, yeah, I can't.
Wisenhunt. Ken Wisenhunt. That's his
Wisenhunt,
name.
Okay.
So, yeah, anyway, I'm going to Colts. I'm going with the Colts in this game.
All right. Well, next we've got the Chargers at the Chiefs.
This good is another game. Good matchup.
Yeah, it was a good game.
Chargers are on a win streak. They barely squeaked out that win. I mean, they you know, strung together. I don't know why I can't speak right now. A really good comeback against the 49ers and are playing with a purpose. And Chiefs, not so much. They still have not thrown a touchdown to a wide receiver this entire season. I think that's amazing.
I thought
amazing.
In that game when they brought it up, it was because he did.
I think he still hasn't.
Wow,
saying,
that's so
crazy.
Weird.
And he's still a good quarterback. I'm going to have to go with the Chargers. I think they're a little more determined, a little more to play for right now, and that's going to be my pick.
All right, Chargers and Chiefs. Yeah, this is a very interesting game. Cause the Chiefs are a good team with a good quarterback, and what's the guy's name? Not the wide receiver, obviously. The running guy. Or maybe he's like a tight end or something. I forget his
name.
Jamal
Charles?
Yeah. Man, that guy's...
Yeah, he's really good.
Yeah, he's crazy good. But I think you're right. I think the Chargers have more to play for. They're more determined. Like, we have to win this game if we want to make the playoffs, you know?
Right.
And the Chiefs, like, they're not making the playoffs,
yeah,
no matter what.
I don't think so, yeah.
So...
Well, I think they're one of those that if several things happen, right, they could make it. The Chargers win and they get in.
Okay, well, I still think the Chargers...
Yeah, the Chargers, they win, they're in, so I think, you know, and they're on a good string, so.
Yeah. Yeah, they've had a few good comeback games. The one against the Ravens, like in week like 12 or 11 or whatever.
Yeah.
Quality. I think I picked the Ravens to win, and Chargers came back and won it. Like, you know.
Yeah.
So I'm going to go Chargers on the road. I almost went Chiefs. I almost wanted to say I think you're right, but I'm going to go Chiefs. Yeah. But I think Chargers.
Won't be surprising, obviously, but yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right, next we have a divisional game. Jets, or I guess they're mostly divisional.
I think they're all divisional games. I think every Jets single one
Dolphins.
Of them.
Yeah.
Jets and Dolphins. Well, the Dolphins are obviously a better team. The Jets have added some good players to their team. And the Jets are one of those teams, like last week, you know, against the Patriots. Like, they played the Patriots hard every time. Mm. Every single time. Like, we seemed to lose. Like, I remember... it was a few years ago. We played like it was like week 2 Thursday night game against the Jets, and I think we lost.
Mm-hmm.
Like they have our number. They know how to play us. They know how to play us tough.
Yeah.
Luckily this season, it was last season we lost to them as well. Right. Early in the season, we beat them later in the season, didn't we?
Right, right. Yeah, yeah, exactly.
Yeah. So
most years we split it with them. They hardly ever sweep them. So.
Yeah. So but this year, luckily, we did win both of those games. Both of them. Barely.
Yeah.
This one.
They win against us. It's barely. It's every time. It's
tough. Yeah. Yeah. Like the first game, it was in overtime, wasn't it? We had to block a field goal.
Uh-huh, right.
Yeah. Like, how lucky do you have to be?
Yeah.
So, the Dolphins. It was last year. If we didn't lose to the Dolphins, we would have got the number one seed over the Broncos.
Because
we played the Dolphins in like week 14 or 15 or something like that.
Right.
16 maybe. We lost them.
Yeah.
You know, the Dolphins know how to beat us, too. Obviously, they beat us week one.
Yeah.
This year.
They look good against us in the second game, too, for the first half. The beginning, but yeah, then they fell apart.
It's weird, because in game one, we dominated the first half, and then they completely dominated the second half. Yeah. So it's kind of weird that it was opposite, yeah. But I'm going to go Dolphins against the Jets. Dolphins are home. They play well at home. They have a much better quarterback. They're just a better team. Dolphins.
Yeah, I am going to disagree with you as much as I hate the Jets.
Wow.
I don't know what it is. I mean, I hate Rex Ryan. I don't know why. I mean, not only as a Patriots fan, he's just an idiot. Like, every year, I guarantee a Super Bowl and coming out all this nonsense.
Yeah, he's a fucking loser.
Yeah, I mean, they say, like, oh, he's a guy you can get a beer with and all this, but it's like, that's not head coach material. It's the guy that you go get a beer with, but... I wouldn't get a beer with him. I think he's an idiot. But my point is that for whatever reason, the players want to play hard for him. And I think they really want him to get this win, after that loss against the Patriots.
Yeah.
Fuck that. I picked the Dolphins.
Nice. Yes.
Awesome. I won't be surprised, but yeah, I'm going to go with the Dolphins.
Yeah, the Jets, they're not as bad as the record says. You know, because for a while they were what, like 0-6 and like 2
lose
and
games, but they're always really tight. A lot of them are. They don't usually get blown out. They strong defense.
But yeah, I had to go Dolphins as well. Yeah, they're better. All right, next the Saints and the Bucks.
Saints again. That's the team that I keep feeling like they're going to win. They're going to just dominate and play, you know, to their standard, at least in my mind. And you know, maybe I'm thinking about the Super Bowl a few years ago, but they're not all that different. They still have Drew Brees and, you know, the coach. So, this one's against the Buccaneers. Buccaneers are for a terrible division. They're the weak link in that division.
Yeah, how sad is that?
Yeah, and Saints, strange enough, have been playing better on the road this year. So, Saints on the road.
Yeah. Yeah, I didn't even think about that. In a terrible, terrible division, you're the worst.
Yeah, right.
That's so funny. Huh. But like you said, the Saints have been playing better on the road. They haven't won a home game this year. Mm. So, against the Bucks, I'm going to go Saints on the road for the win.
All right. Next, we have the Eagles at the hated Giants.
Ooh. Eagles have not been playing well lately. They lost 3 in a row, didn't they? Or 2 in a row.
At least 2. I don't remember if it's been 3, but...
Because last week they lost to Washington, right?
Right. Surprise loss, yeah.
And then week 15 was... Their loss...
Cowboys, yeah, they lost to the Cowboys. That was
and then week 14, they lost to the Seahawks, right? Yeah, so that's 3 weeks in a row. Week 13 was... A bye?
Yeah, perhaps by. No, they won against the Cowboys. That was the week they won.
Oh, that was Thanksgiving? Week 13? Yeah. Okay, mm-hmm. Yeah. So they had three losses in a row, week 14, 15, and 16. Mm. So, wow. Yeah,
the time flies.
Yeah, I know. Crazy. We're already past Christmas.
Yeah.
I'm going to go Eagles on the road to beat the Giants. Fuck the Giants.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more. Just took the words right from my mouth. I think they're still a better team. It's unfortunate they lost those last couple of games, especially the game against the Cowboys.
It's, yeah. And they that was a good game. They started to come back. It's hard to play well. Yeah.
I think if Nick Foles was still out there, it's too bad that Sanchez. I mean, he's been playing all right, but.
Yeah, he's had a few good games and a few
Nick, not so good games. You know,
Sanchez games.
Yeah.
I said Nick Sanchez. I meant Mark Sanchez.
Put them together. Maybe they'd win a game. Even with Sanchez, they're still better than the Giants, so Eagles.
Yeah. All right, next we have the Panthers at the Falcons. This is a good game. This is an important game.
Right, yeah.
Sadly.
Yeah, it's win or go home. It's the one for them. It's another playoff game, so. Falcons at home. I think they're a better team. Panthers haven't been good all season. I mean, none of that division really has, but. I think Matty Ice is better than Cam Newton and the rest of the team, the receivers, everything, it's better, so, and they're at home, so let's go Falcons.
Did you say Matty Ice?
Yeah, Matt Ryan, that's what his nickname, Matty Ice.
Yeah. Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Okay, Falcons at home, Panthers on the road. This is that half game ahead, right?
Yeah,
69, but it doesn't really matter. Yeah, so whoever wins this game goes to the playoffs, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's sad that it's under 500 team is going to go to the playoffs. Well, with the 7-8-1, it's under 500, but it's like half a game.
Yeah, but still.
Yeah. Oh, I'm going to have to go Panthers on the road.
Right.
I think that. I mean, the Falcons have been playing well lately, but so have the Panthers. They took that 5-6 weeks off. Yeah. You know, lost 5-6 in a row or whatever. But I think now they're back. They're determined. You know, now it's like, hey, we have a chance to go to the playoffs.
Maybe we should start playing.
Yeah, maybe we should pick this shit up. So I think the Panthers are going to win on the road to beat the Falcons and go to the playoffs.
Next, we have Raiders at Broncos.
Ooh. The Broncos haven't been playing that well lately.
No, the Raiders have.
Yeah, even that win they had a few weeks ago against whoever it was, week 15. The Chargers.
Oh, yeah.
Even then, like, they didn't really play that well.
That's when they started running the ball a lot. And
yeah, like, that was the game where he didn't throw a touchdown pass. Mm-hmm. So, I think. And, yeah, like you said, the Raiders are playing well. Better than they have all season.
Yeah.
But it's the Broncos. They're at home. They are so much better than the Raiders. I'm going to have to go Broncos.
Yeah, I don't see how I can really justify an upset in this one. I wouldn't be surprised. I mean, again, the Raiders have had some surprising wins lately, and the Broncos have had some surprising losses. Peyton Manning just doesn't look like himself. He's saying he's going to play next season, but...
Is he now?
Yeah. Oh. Well, he was saying he wasn't.
I thought this was supposed to be his last season.
Oh, really?
I think that's what he said last year.
No, I heard recently that they said he's talking about coming back, so... I think it's a mistake, because I think he is starting that decline that I think Brady won't for at least a couple more years, but...
Well, Brady's a few years younger.
Yeah, but... In any case, Broncos, even on Peyton's worst day, I think, are better than the Raiders. So,
yeah.
And they're at home, so let's go.
Yeah, as much as we hate the Broncos and want to see Peyton Manning lose, he is a really good quarterback. Yeah,
either way, I think they'd be a second seed, so it doesn't matter if they win this game to me. But
I
still like to see him lose, but anyway, yeah, let's go Broncos.
All right, next we have the Lions at the Packers. Another really good game.
Interesting one, yeah. Although I think I heard that the Lions haven't won at the Packers since like 97 or something ridiculous.
It's like 91. It's been like 24 years or some shit.
Oh my God, that's crazy. I think it's going to happen any year. It'd be this year. Lions have played better than I remember in recent history.
Yeah.
Packers, though, have been playing better at home than I remember in recent history, as good as they played in the last few years.
Yeah, they're so good at home. It's ridiculous. Like, they're better than the Patriots are at home.
Right.
Like, the Patriots are hard to beat at home.
Right.
But the Packers are just ridiculous. They blow people out of the water. Like, it's crazy. Yeah.
Especially Aaron Rodgers. Like, that game against the Patriots, I was blown away. I mean, I've always known he's a good quarterback, but, I mean, strike every single throw. But,
yep.
I have to go Packers here. I'd like to see the Lions get a win. I mean, that's pretty pathetic that within the same division that they can't get a win in 20 years. But we'll go Packers here.
Yeah, with the Lions, they beat the Packers earlier in the season, right before they said relax and everything.
Right. And, that was at home though.
Yeah, that was the Lions playing at home. So now the Lions, they've had a few more losses. The Packers went on that huge streak. Mm. You know,
and then they lost against the Bills.
Yeah, which is really weird. Was that last week?
Week before, I think.
Week before, yeah. Oh, yeah. Last week they barely, but they beat somebody, but it wasn't like a blowout game. The
Buccaneers, yeah.
Oh, yeah, the Bucs, yeah, 20-3, like.
I guess a blowout by Buccaneers standard or by normal standards, but not against the Buccaneers.
Yeah, and not for the Packers. Like the Packers, that should have been 43-3,
right,
or something. But so yeah, the last couple of weeks, and even against the Patriots, like the Patriots, they kept in there.
Mm.
You know, it wasn't a blowout game.
Right. Like they could easily have won that game if not for a couple of bad calls and throws.
Yeah, yeah. Bad decisions on, you know, oh, it's fourth, let's just kick a field goal instead of going for the touchdown.
Right.
You know.
And miss the field goal.
Yeah. Even though a field goal wouldn't have fucking helped us at all.
Right. Either way, yeah.
Yeah. But anyway, I do think the Packers are better than the Lions. Even on the Lions' best day, I think, at this point in the season, like earlier, the Lions did win, but I think at this point in the season, the Packers are better. So I'm going to go Packers.
All right. Next, we have Cardinals at the 49ers.
All right. Well, we beat the Niners earlier in the season.
Mm.
And like I should have said with the last game, it's tough to beat the same team twice. Mm. Like I said with one of the other games, Cowboys and Redskins.
Yeah.
It's tough to beat the same team twice. And at this point, I think both teams are on par with each other.
Yeah.
Because the Niners have potential to be really good. And we've seen the Cardinals be the best team in the league the whole season up until a couple of weeks ago. But we're playing our third string quarterback, maybe even fourth string.
Yeah, like it's a toss up between the third, fourth, whatever order you
want. I think we're going with our fourth, the Thomas guy.
Yeah.
He's our third. Because he came in when Drew Stanton went down a couple weeks ago to finish the game.
But then there's another guy they've been talking about.
But then we went with the other guy last week.
Mm.
And then this week we're going back with Thomas.
Yeah.
Or whatever his name is. So I think he's our third, but we went with our fourth last week.
Right.
But we're going back to our third this week. And but I think Kaepernick's probably a better quarterback than that guy.
Oh, yeah.
He definitely has more experience. And the Cardinals are on the road, but with that many, it's next man up.
Yeah.
I don't think we can do it. I think the Niners are going to win at home.
Yeah, this is one I really hate to agree, but
excuse me.
Bless you. I think if we had Kaepernick, I think if we had Kaepernick playing quarterback on the Cardinals, we would dominate them, but as much as I hate Kaepernick, but I'm saying, even he is that much better than these guys were putting out there. So
yeah.
I mean, the Cardinals keep surprising us. We keep saying, oh, how many people can you lose? And then they win games, but not lately. Not against quality teams, for sure. And by the way, did you hear that Drew Stanton, they found there's an infection in his knee now? So
no, last I heard, he was going into surgery.
Okay. See, they were saying that he was going to be ready for the playoffs. He's going to be out for a couple weeks, but then they, something unrelated apparently caused an infection, and he may not be available for the playoffs.
Oh, any of them are first round out.
Unfortunate, because I mean, that basically no chance in the playoffs. But
yep.
I mean, so what they've accomplished this year, I think, is pretty phenomenal. And
yeah, it's very phenomenal for all these injuries. You know, like, oh, he went down, bringing this guy. Oh, that guy went down, bringing this guy.
Yeah, I mean, Bruce Arians, like, coach of the year. I mean, he still finds a way, but
yeah, definitely.
I can't go for the, I guess it would be an upset. So, yeah, I'm going to go 49ers. Even though they have nothing to play for, and the Cardinals have seeding to play for, but I don't think it's going to be enough, so.
Yeah. All right, next we have the Rams at the Seahawks.
Rams have also been surprising me a lot. I guess not lately.
Yeah, they've lost a few in a row, haven't they?
Yeah. But yeah, they had a couple of really high points in the season. Seahawks, man, they are scary good right now. They're back to that championship form. So
yep.
I get to go with them at home. But Rams, I won't be surprised if they come out with a win, but we'll go Seahawks.
Yeah, the Rams, they've had the... at first, they were surprising wins, then it kind of just became regular that they were winning.
Right.
But yeah, the last couple games, they haven't been doing.
A blowout, they had like, it was like 52-0, something like that, win. It was like a
against, I forget who. Was that the Thanksgiving week? Yeah, 52-0 against the Raiders, That was after the Raiders got their first win, too.
Right.
And then they lost last week, right? Yeah, 27-37 Giants. So yeah, they haven't.
Oh, that's right.
They haven't been playing as well as they were mid-season, but yeah, the Seahawks—they're just—they're back to being one of the better teams in the league. For a while there, it was like, oh yeah, yeah, they're good. They're probably going to make the playoffs, but Arizona's going to take the number one seed.
Right.
But now it's like the Seahawks are the number one seed at the moment, right?
Right. Yeah.
And even if they lose this, do they keep number one? Or if they lose, Green Bay wins.
When we get back to the one seed,
Arizona?
Cardinals would get the one seed. If they won and the Seahawks lost, that would be
11-4 and
I think Seahawks are also.
Oh yeah, okay. So if we win and the Seahawks win, we still get the number one seed.
No. No, if we win and the Seahawks lose, that would be how we get the one seed.
Okay, because yeah, the Seahawks beat us.
Yeah.
That's right. Okay. They beat us both games? Yeah?
Yes.
Yeah, okay, yeah. So the Packers, no matter what, won't even get a... No, because if we lose, they'll get the number one or two seed. If we and the Seahawks lose, Packers get number one if they win.
I think so, yeah.
Because right now it's a four-way tie between Seahawks, Packers, Lions, and Cardinals. Wow, that's crazy.
Mm.
Yeah, I'm going to go Seahawks at home. They're better than the Rams. Yeah. They're clearly back to their... Super Bowl caliber ways, so
yeah.
Seahawks at home.
All right, and our final game of the season, of the regular season, is the Bengals at the Steelers.
Wow, the final game of the season is the Bengals and Steelers.
Yeah, they moved it up to the nighttime game. Maybe there was a Steelers fan organizing that.
Yeah, I heard like because of wins and losses, they rearranged who plays at what time and everything.
Right. Yeah,
it's kind of weird. And it wasn't set already.
Yeah, which is weird.
Yeah. It's crazy. The Bengals finally got a win under the lights against one of the better Broncos teams in the league. The Broncos. So maybe they're finally over that hump and they can be like, all right, yeah, we can play under the lights, no problem.
They were playing intense. Like that was. They looked like they were in a whole other class in the first half that I saw against them.
Yeah.
Broncos were just, kind of just indifferent looking, and the Bengals were charged up and on fire, jumping all over the place like they wanted that win.
Yeah, they did. They needed that win.
Yeah.
Because right now it's 10-4-1 and 10-5, so they got that half game.
Yeah.
I like the Bengals, and I don't like the Steelers.
Exactly.
But the Steelers are a good team. I mean, all season long, except for those two games where he just fucking had six touchdown passes in a row for two games, the Steelers have been kind of one of those under-the-radar teams. Like, they got their wins. Those two games were, let's talk about the Steelers, and then it kind of went back to, they just win their games.
Yeah, back to mediocrity.
Yeah. I mean, they won 10 games, that 10th win is always hard. But, oh man, on the road, under the big lights, the Bengals, I don't know, the Steelers are playing really well right now. I'm going to have to go Steelers at home for the win.
Yeah, I hope you're wrong. I think the Bengals are going to have that same intensity, and I think that they're going to come out and beat the Steelers. And
yeah?
I hope. I mean, I wouldn't say I like the Bengals, at least not as much as you do. I don't really care. I don't dislike them, and I don't love them either, but Steelers, I don't care for them. I don't like the fans that I've known, and just Pittsburgh, I don't really give a shit, so.
Yeah.
I don't really give a shit about Cincinnati either, but
yeah.
But I'm gonna go Bengals. I think that they're a better team right now, I think they did get over that hump. So hopefully, we will find out.
We will find out. And wow, 16 games on one day. No Thursday. No Monday.
That's weird. I think it has Saturday. Yeah, I thought there was a couple game weeks where there was two Saturday or. 2 weeks of Saturday games, but
yeah,
maybe not. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe it's just the 1 week.
Yeah, it's just weird. There's no Thursday or Monday night games.
Yeah,
I guess I never really paid that much attention.
Yeah,
to when the games.
Well, now that we're here in this week, I'm kind of remembering it being like that other years. I don't know.
Never. Yeah. Anyway. All right. Well, those are our picks for Week 17, the final week of the 2014 NFL season.
Crazy.
The final week. Wow. And the Patriots got the number one fucking seed. Yeah, that is so cool.
NFL.
Yep. Wow. And they secured it last week. Like, always, the NFC, like, everyone's, right now, it's up for grabs.
Yeah.
So, wow, that is crazy. Who would have thunk after going 2-2 at that crazy, crappy blowout game we played
against the Chiefs
that we would come out number one seed?
Right. That is nuts. I thunk.
I believe in Bill and Brady. That's good. All right, everybody. Well, tune in next week when we give you our recap of Week 17 and who made it to the playoffs and who didn't make it to the playoffs. And we'll talk about the first wild card week of the playoffs.
Yep.
And we'll see who those teams are, because right now we have no idea.
Yeah.
So tune in next week, ladies and gentlemen. As always, we are your hosts, Movie Master Mike.
And Boston Boy.
All right, see you later.
Fuck the Jets.
Yeah, fuck the Giants. Did you say Matty Ice?